They're Australia's favourite besties who sit on the couch and watch TV together. Fans were ecstatic when Adam and Simon returned to the couch for Gogglebox last year. And we're just so excited to have the boys live on the show today with us. G'day, fellas.
Hey, team. How are you?
Hi, everyone.
Great to see you.
Very good. Now, 2021 was a huge year for the both of you. Most importantly, you're back on Gogglebox. Why did you decide to return?
Well, we got asked midway through lockdown in Melbourne and we thought it was a nice excuse to hang out together and work. So we thought it was too good an opportunity to say no to.
It's like the dream job, isn't it?
Oh, that's great. Yeah, well, we're delighted you guys are back. But Adam, you're on the couch for a different reason, not too recently. You had a case of COVID-19. How are you feeling?
I'm back to full health. Three vaccine shots has certainly kept me in good stead. But Sim started calling himself Neo from The Matrix because we hung out together the whole week before I turned positive and he managed to dodge every bullet that came his way.
Now, Adam, you had a busy year last year. You got married, bought a house and now you have some really exciting news of a different kind. Congratulations, you've got a bub on the way.
Thank you. Yes, due in May. So if you guys have any tips, Tristan, if you've got any tips, mate, I am taking tips like they're going out of fashion at the moment. So very exciting. But, yeah, extremely nerve-wracking times because I have absolutely no idea what I'm doing.
Oh, hey, none of us do. So the only tip is get your sleep in now. I know that everyone says that, but look, it really is fantastic news. We really are delighted for you. Simon, but congratulations are also in order for you because you popped the question. How did the proposal go?
Mate, well, successful. She said yes, which was great. No, it was great. It was easily the best night of my life on New Year's Eve. Adam had a really big year, as you said, and I thought I had to just get one. We hang out so much that everyone comes up and just congratulates him all the time. So I had to get, like, one back, just get some attention back on me.
Simon, did Adam give you any advice about popping the question?
Yeah, he did. He actually told me when asking the question, make the speech really long so that your future fiancé can sit in that moment. He also paid for the ring too, which helped. So that was like some really handy advice.
Oh, that's kind of nice.
Yeah. Right?
The best friend you need.
Yeah,
huh?
The best
exactly.
friend you need.
I paid him back though, yeah. Don't worry. He didn't just pay for it all.
Now, the pair of you host a podcast, The Adam and Simon Show. And in fact, Simon, we hear you won a bet. Let's take a listen to that.
This was sent through by Shoei.
Okay.
Firstborn has to go for the other person's footy team. Your kid has to be a Brisbane supporter if you pop one out before me. Yep.
That was a video taken from an excerpt of an episode of Gogglebox where Adam and I made a bet that whoever had a kid first, that firstborn child would go for the other's football team. And you were very confident at the time because you had no partner. I was in a relationship. So your firstborn child, which has just been announced.
Yeah.
All things going well.
Yeah.
Welcome to the Kangaroos.
There we go.
Go the Kangas. Go the Kangas.
I'd double or quits it and go for the name.
Mate.
Deal's a deal, right?
Well, look, you've got to pick your target, I think. I was never going to get the name, so I think footy teams are right, but he's trying to renege. It's no good.
Yeah,
he's trying to renege. He needs some sense spoken into him, I think.
Our podcast is called The Adam and Simon Show, and we've talked about it before Christmas. There's a couple of episodes about the bet there, but I think we're going to have an episode coming up where we get the lawyers involved because I can't have my firstborn child supporting the Kangaroos.
But you got it.
And maybe I'm going to have to sacrifice and call the kid Simon Jr. Who knows?
I like that. Girl or boy, it works, I think.
Yeah, exactly.
I think it works really well.
We'll do it. Simon,
yes.
Your Instagram bio, that reveals you have an OnlyFans page called Daily Footman.
I do.
Is this for real?
Mate, this is for real. Again, this is a bit of a podcast jaunt. Well, we just heard that, you know, there's articles pop up that OnlyFans people make heaps of cash. And we decided, well, I didn't. Adam decided that, you know, I'm actually a four-time feature on Feedy McFeetface on Instagram, which is an Instagram foot page. And we thought, you know, dollar signs.
So basically, Simon thinks he has beautiful feet.
I do.
And I thought, how can we leverage these beautiful feet? So on the podcast, The Adam and Simon Show, we absolutely tried to... We talked to people who were interested in feet to work out what kind of photos people like.
Talked to OnlyFans models about how it works, best way to do it. And we've been incredibly successful. We currently have zero fans and make no money. So there's just photos of my feet on the internet floating out there.
Zero fans but fabulous feet.
Exactly.
What is your foot care regime?
Geez, I go more of the rough rider type setup. There's kind of really no care. I wash them, clip them, that's about it. But just real natural.
We did ask people who are fans of feet what kind of feet do they need to be kept in with the dogs. Do the dogs need to be kept in good nick? And they said some people really like that rugged, just a bit brush. You know, it's almost like someone with a bit of facial hair.
Yep.
That's what Simon's feet are if you're looking for them.
Fresh out of footy boot setup.
Well, now they're a full moneymaker. Yeah. So day to day then, do you kind of have to hide the merchandise through the day?
Absolutely, mate.
Socks they're on the beach.
Always in brand new socks, very flush, new shoes every week. You know, you've got to maintain the whole thing. It's you just got to look after the merchandise.
Now, Simon and Adam, last year you kept us entertained in the jungle. Well, and your feet as well, I guess. We probably got a glimpse of it. I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here. Have you been watching this year? And if you could have given any advice to celebs, what would you have told them?
I think it's probably a little bit too much PTSD for us watching that. The eating challenges for Simon. The amount of goop and fish guts that I swam in. So I've tried to avoid it for the moment, but the best advice is there's one really comfy spot on the log, and if you can manage to hold that one comfy spot on the log, you'll have a much more enjoyable experience because that thing is just like concrete.
Lovely. Good advice. Quite
I can't
sound,
decide whether I'd
think.
Want to do a food challenge or just not eat.
Yeah.
It's a hot topic now at the moment. Guys, it's always a pleasure to speak to you. Congratulations. You two guys are awesome, and it's great to see you guys back. You can catch the boys' podcast, The Adam and Simon Show, on Listener and wherever you get your podcasts to. Plus, Gogglebox Australia will return with new episodes soon on Foxtel and Network 10. Adam and Simon, keep being legend, lads. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, guys.
All the best. Go Kangaroos.